This is the Cayo Perico Solo Elite Challenge Guide with the Kosatka approach. These are the options I chose. When you start the heist, start by swimming towards the drainage tunnel. The fastest way possible to cut the gate open and save yourself some time is by doing it one by one. It goes way faster if you do that than going all the way down and then all the way up again for each row. Do the same as I do until you've cut them all open. Now swim towards the end of the tunnel. It's important that you carefully follow each step right now in order to complete the heist without getting detected. Once you're up here, this is where you have to be careful since bodies can get spotted by the juggernaut and the other guards in the compound. First, go up the stairs. Over here, you want to take this exact route. Hug the right side of the building and take a left turn over here once you're out of these guards vision. Now go up the stairs. Over here, you can keep running in a straight line and climb over the fence. Then take a left turn and on the right side over here, you want to go up the stairs. Over here, you will see the first guard that you want to take down. Now go up the stairs where you will find one more guard to take down. When you've done that as well, if you're lucky by now, you will have found the gate keys. Take some extra cash out of the safe. In my case, I ended up getting 66k. If you don't have the gate keys, you'll have to do the fingerprint cloner hack over here. Walk towards this place. If you're doing it on normal mode, you'll have to do 3 hacks in total over here in order to get to the primary target. If you do have the gate keys, go down the stairs. You can jump over the stairs to speed this up a little bit. Once you're here, go to the left side and what you want to do is jump over this fence. On the right side over here, you will find the door to unlock to get towards the primary target way faster. Over here, you will also have to do the fingerprint cloner hacker, but instead of doing 3 hacks, over here you just have to do 1 hack, which is going to save you a lot of time. Now what you want to do over here is to simply match up the pattern as shown on the right side and you will complete the hack within just a few seconds. Once you've done that, wait for the successful screen to disappear and take the exact same route that I take, which is just going straight forward. Now cut this door open with your cutting torch to get to the primary target. I managed to get the ruby necklace, which is worth $1 million. When you're cutting through the glass, you want to pay attention to the heat of it. Overheat it until it's almost at the end and stop when it's around this place. Repeat this 3 more times and you will cut through the glass real quick to get the $1 million. Now that we've collected the primary target, we need to get the secondary loot to fill up the loot bag. Follow the route that I take to make your way safely out of the compound without getting detected. If you open the door and see the juggernaut close to you, just walk forward until you're at this point and jump over the wall to make it way faster. Now stay out of the guard's vision and run towards the yellow circle marked over here. We've now got the primary target, but of course want to get the secondary loot so you get more money and complete the elite challenge. I'll show you exactly which route to follow in order to not get detected. But before I show you that, if this video is already helpful for you, make sure to subscribe and hit that like button for more videos like this. Once you're here, run up towards this guy that's on the left side, take him down, and what you wanna do is get on the bike. You want to go straight between the trees and the other plants until you arrive at this place where you will see a guard riding in a car. You want to kill him so he doesn't spot the bodies of the guards that you just killed. If you want to be extra safe, get off your bike and use your main weapon. Once you've done that, go back to where we just were. Take the exact same route as I do to not get in the other guards' their vision. You can just follow this road and you will be good to go. Here, take down this guard first. If you want to make sure that you kill these two without messing it up, get off your bike and do the same thing as I do. The guard on the right side, you can completely ignore. Now, take down the camera and you can use the bike to go to the secondary loot. Follow this route that I'm taking. You want to keep going straight and get off the road into the mountains. Here you want to go between the trees and make sure to stay on the right side in the middle of the mountain. Keep going straight until you're at this point. Over here, you want to go first left where you will see a guard and a camera. Take down the guard first and after the camera. Now you can take all the loot that's in here In my case, I ended up getting one stack of cash. The most valuable secondary loot that you can get is the white stuff, which is something you always want to take. Underneath that, you got the green stuff. And the last one, which is the worst, is cash as the secondary loot. If your bag is still not full like mine at this moment, go outside with the bike you just drove on and kill the following guards to make it to the next loot place without getting detected. You want to do this as fast as you can without alerting anyone. Make sure to stand out of the helicopter's vision, else you will get detected. Now take down the other guard that's walking over here and you can safely collect all the other loot that's in there. Now that your loot bag is full, we need to escape Cayo Perico. Go back where we just were and jump onto one of the boats that are in the water. It doesn't matter if you get spotted at this point, you will still complete the elite challenge as long as you escape. Now simply take a left turn and keep driving forwards until you've escaped the enemies. I ended up completing it in 8 minutes and 6 seconds, and because I didn't fail any hacks, I got a full loot bag, I ended up completing the elite challenge. But this video is useless if you don't know how to start the final heist with the correct setups. Check out this video where I show you exactly